Channel 5 News here. We have a breaking story to report. Justin Rosich from Nevada is up, third hunt with us. And the news of the day is that he has not waited until the last day at 10 a.m. to shoot a buck.
That is for sure. Got her done on day 3 this time, not day 6.
Tell us what happened.
Well, it's been really cold the last couple days, so just been kind of hunkering down, trying to weather out the cold and just be patient, and sure as hell, here he came. So that was it. He was about 5 minutes behind a doe and a fawn. So
okay.
They'd kind of come out, and I kind of looked back a couple times, and I thought, better keep an eye. And a little while later, he popped out, kind of nose to the ground on the same trail, and yeah, worked out good, I think. We'll go see, make sure, but I think he's down.
Let's go see what we got. You sound pretty pumped, so.
I'm a little chilly, but I'm pretty excited
too. you'll warm up right away. Okay, let's go. Well, we just got down to the bottom here. We're in a big steep gorge. You could see up on the top of Mount Everest. This is blind where he shot from. We drove the sled down here and we can see blood from his trail. And like Justin said, he figures he's, you know, somewhere around a big white tree over there. Well, I look in and that big solitary white poplar, you can see in the center of the screen, there is a dead whitetail buck laying there. We can see him, he's about 60 yards away, and he looks to be a pretty good deer, so. Congrats have been said, someone's happy. Let's go see what kind of deer we got.
Absolutely.
Let's do it. I know which deer this is. This is one I got pictures of for years.
I remember you showing me this one. He had that short GT.
He's a tank.
Look at that freaking
thing. What a deer. Maybe just tuck his tongue in there. Good job, Tex. I knew this was a big deer too. Look at the mass on that. I'd say we're doing a cape job. Look at his neck.
Yeah, look at that thing. I told you, look at that. Looks like a 300 pounder on the hoof.
Just a, what, talk about a mature buck. Just a big old mature, heavy. He's got a little kicker point there.
He's got two little guys down here.
Yeah.
Little brows.
What a deer. Congratulations, buddy.
Thanks, that thing is a freaking beast.
That deer is why guys come here. That's why you come here. Big, heavy, chocolate antlered mass, mature, big bush whitetail.
Wow.
Congrats, buddy.
Beast, thanks.
Congrats. ...2022 AWGS rifle whitetail wolf hunts. And it's our first week. And we got our first buck on the ground. And it looks like Justin from Nevada has done something wrong. It's his third hunt with us, and it's not Saturday morning at 10 a.m. It's Wednesday afternoon at about 3, and there's a deer on the ground, so he must be doing something right.
Yeah, I probably figured I shouldn't pass this one on day 3.
Thank you.
He's a tank.
Yeah.
Sure. But yeah, the first couple trips, waited till the last day, and killed nice bucks and mature bucks, but not this mature.
Yeah.
This one's, I think, definitely got some age on him. You can tell by the size of his body, he's just a beast. So really super excited. He's got some major mass going on. He's got a couple little extra kickers coming out of the front of his pedicles there. So yeah, just fun hunt again. We dealt with a little bit colder temperatures the first couple days than what I'm used to. Trying to bundle up and stay warm. The toes were getting froze off, but kept sticking with it. And yep, afternoon, day three, had quite a few more deer sightings. I think I saw 8 or 9 deer today total. So
okay.
It seemed like things were picking up a little bit. And a fawn had come out in the cut to the north of me. And I kept looking at it going, I think that's a fawn. But then I kind of convinced myself it was a doe because I never saw the doe. And she kind of fed out there for a while and then went back in the woods. And then probably an hour later, a doe and a fawn came out in the same spot. So I thought, eh, it probably was a fawn. And there's the mom. And they kind of came across the cut line. And I thought, well, probably keep an eye on that and see if there's something going on behind. And probably not 10 minutes later, he came out right on the same trail, nose on the ground, right on him. And I was on him immediately and had to yell probably 6 or 7 times to finally get him to stop. He kind of had one thing on his mind, I think. It took a little bit to get him out of his little daze. So he stopped broadside in the cut there about 250 yards and let him have it. And it was a good shot again. And he only probably went, 100 yards?
Well, I didn't even go that far.
So
maybe 80?
I'm super, super happy. He's a big, heavy, mature 10 with a couple extras. So we kind of talked thinking maybe 8 or 9 year old buck potentially.
Yeah.
So
yeah,
that's way cool. It's impressive how these things can live out here to start with for that long. So
yeah,
super privileged to be able to take one that's this old. So
it makes the trophy that much more meaningful. It really does.
I'm stoked. So
just turn his head this way, but keep his skull plate level. That's it. Just kind of turn it and then, oh, what a deer. Turn him a little bit further too. Yeah. What a buck. Congratulations, Justin.
Thanks,
man. That's a heck of a deer. That's the kind of deer we all hope that every one of our clients kill. So yep, they're here. They're not behind every tree, but you just got to put in your time.
Yep. You've got a good method. Stick it out.
Yeah.
You know, keep watching the same spot for as long as it takes. And a lot of times something will happen. You just kind of got to be alert and ready when it does.
That's exactly it.
But yeah, once again, you know, great accommodations. Staying in the lodge is great. The food's great. Folks are good. Good group of hunters again. So yeah, we had a good time again. Still got a few more days to kind of get things taken care of. Hopefully John can get one down in a few more days and we'll see what everybody else does. So
that'd be nice. Congrats again, Justin.
Thanks.
John's just getting down out of the pod, you can see. Justin and I have come in, and John's fired a shot, it's probably only about 175 yards. He vectored us into the spot where he felt the deer was hit, and as you can see,
he's
definitely hit. His hit solid, and his track running away is... he's messed up and he's losing ground as he's running away to the low spot. So I don't think we're gonna have to go too far. It's a beautiful day out. Beautiful day. We'll see. Things are looking good
real good
for this team from Nevada, that they're gonna go 3 for 3 3 years in a row and both kill bucks. So we'll see what happens. Stand by for a follow-up report from the Channel 5 News. Hey, look, there's a Sasquatch coming down the cut line.
Oh, God.
Those are pretty rare.
They're rare.
Look at the step in that young man. He's got a... Good morning, young man. step up here and have a look at this blood sign. There's where you hit him right there. Is that good?
Can you see that?
Oh yeah.
Can you see that?
No, I can see all the splatter and I can see the big clump there.
It's a big clump of hair and you can see where he's like, he almost hit the ground here trying to run away.
Where's the hair?
There's a bunch of hair in behind. It's what you want to see. You hit him in the side.
Well, so, I can see all of the red. There's a ton of blood there. Okay. Did you take the gun, Mo? Or I need to go potty.
What, you need to do what?
Don't film it.
Don't film it. It's too late. It's already filmed.
Turn that thing off.
We don't like to have much fun around here.
No, you parent. I'll do whatever the hell you want. You're going to anyway. You can always edit it out.
Oh yeah, or leave it in. You know.
So he basically
came right on the trail here. Right.
Yeah, because he's beautiful, dark chestnut colored body, and he came out and then he looked right back and I could, at me, and he wasn't that wide, and I thought, yeah, nice big body though. And then he turned and it looked like he had a 10 frame, so I said, well, I came up here, I was looking for a 10.
So, he's got an 8 and a 9.
Well, there you go.
Yeah, he's probably missing about that.
No shit. If he's like a 13, then I get to keep him, or what? You don't want him, or you just want a 10, right?
He could be better than you think. And of course, Mo always asks the question, is it a good shot?
Yeah.
And I was telling Dean, had time. He was broadside, and he looked so I could see the side of his head. I said, oh, this is good. So, put it right on him. And I had the gun just resting in my hand. So there was a little recoil.
Yeah.
And so when it recoiled, of course, you lose picture to the scope. And I don't like that. It's nice when you can actually see the whack. The thing that always makes it good is when the shot surprises you, then it's probably good. And that gun's trigger goes quick. And then I was almost positive I heard a thump. And that's the other good telltale sign. So, yeah, I definitely think that's a... Do you think he got hit really well and almost...
Yeah, you could see immediately he was losing. He's losing going down. I don't think we're going to have to follow him in there very far. Well, so
he didn't bust ass across here.
Yeah.
You know, it's after the recoil and I looked by the scope and he was going across, but he wasn't going across at any great pace. So
I suspect you hit one.
I figured he was hurting.
I suspect you hit one of his front legs. Just looking at his track that I can see, he looks like a three-legged deer.
Hit his front leg?
I think you hit one of his front legs. So like one of his front legs may have been back and you hit him right through the boiler room and busted one of his legs. Okay. It looks like he's three-legging. But anyways, I think you have to go potty, so we'll let you go
take
potty. I'll turn the camera off for that and then we'll resume later. Sound like a deal?
Day's nice.
What's going on here?
What's going on here? Blowing my nose.
Oh. Anything else?
Well, what's going on here is I guess knowing Dean's modus operandi is we're getting things arranged to take some pictures.
Why is that?
This whitetail.
Which? What whitetail?
This whitetail right here, Dean.
Oh, yeah. That one.
That one. That we just harvested this morning.
What's going on here? What's the steer going on? What's all those points? What's all that points and stuff sticking up there?
I don't know. I have to be candidly honest because I said it over the phone when I saw this deer, which was right about 10 o'clock this morning. He didn't look that wide. when he looked at me, but then when he turned sideways, I could see he was at least a 10. I could see that side over there, so it tells you how well I can judge.
It's fairly wide to me.
Yeah, I would say so. Yeah, I mean, he's not the widest deer in the woods, but
no.
Justin,
no.
Pull that up again a little bit.
But yeah, we dropped in on him. Picked up Justin and brought him in, and the three of us walked in and found him. He didn't go very far, which is always great.
Turn him a bit more, Justin.
Really, really pleasant. Nice surprise.
I'll see.
15 pointer.
Yep. Very nice. Well, how about we get the torture chamber set up for the pictures and video? Are you ready for that?
You got it. Time to stage. Well, it's warm and it's early enough that it's,
oh, yeah.
It's a pleasant day to do it. So,
I'm sure. Well, you did that on purpose, right? Like you passed all those other bucks and it was cold. You stayed in one day.
Dean, there's never been a time that I wasn't up here that one of my primary considerations was your well-being. And your comfort. And I really felt bad last year when you had to dig out of the snow and everything and damn near kill yourself doing it. So I'm just happy to be able to accommodate your needs.
Well, thank you. And that's why you're allowed to come back every time.
You're very welcome.
Congratulations, man.
Mutual admiration. No, this is absolutely not often you harvest something, and when you know, it's always ground shrinkage, always thinking. This is absolutely the opposite. I mean, when we pulled that out from under those trees and all those points sticking all over the place, oh my God.
I could see the inline 12 frame.
Me too. Me too.
And my ass.
That's not a very good job of judging, but I guess better lucky than accomplished.
Exactly. Like Dean talks with his plan, you don't really have a lot of time to look at the horns directly.
No, and that's you're absolutely right, Justin.
You see that they're good enough horns, and you see how big the body is, and it's a mature buck.
And you don't wait around, or you maybe don't get a shot.
Yeah, so. It's kind of like Christmas when you walk up on them, because you don't know exactly what you got there until you see it up close. Yeah. So.
Yeah. Well, that's the one thing. You shoot them. What we're shooting them for is we're shooting them for frame and mass, and you know, make sure that they're mature deer, because 99% of the time, if those things add up and you do that and you walk up and pull that deer's head out of the snow or bush or whatever, you won't be disappointed. You won't.
I say you're absolutely correct. Certainly in this case, that's very appropriate.
Well, one last little look here, and then let's get him.
Son of a gun.
Yeah. Nice surprise.
Beauty. Oh boy.
Let's set him up and take some pics, boys. 2022 AWGS Rifle Whitetail Wolf Hunts. And what do we got here?
What do we have here, Dean?
Yeah.
We have a whitetail.
Oh, okay.
It's appropriate considering it's a whitetail hunt.
There you go. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. That's a good point you make. Okay.
Mm-hmm. Valid. Basic point, but important.
Well, why don't you tell us about your week?
Well, this is the third trip up here for son-in-law Justin, i.e. Mo, and myself. It's been an eventful trip that we drove this time, and the conditions were a little difficult, but we got that handled, and it got pretty cold up here by the previous 2 years. Got colder than the previous 2 years, so that was a little bit difficult. I had requested a stand be put in a certain place, and so Dean was kind enough to accommodate me. When I saw how cold it was, I really wasn't thrilled about being up there, but he was somewhat insistent that if he'd done the work, then I was getting up in the air. Turd in the sky routine. So I was up there. It was a couple mornings. It was western. It was difficult. We got Friday today.
Yep.
It's nice when you lose track of the days. It means you're having a good time. So anyway, we're out here. I was out here Friday on the stand first thing, and the deer had been moving real well last day or two, and so I had high hopes and got out here 7:30, saw a few does and on each side of the pod. And around about 10 o'clock, this fella, he steps out into the cut line from the east side. He just came out, so he was totally exposed, and he stopped, and he looked right at me, probably only, 150 yards, maybe, it's close.
I think it was 163 we ranged it.
Okay, beautiful. I could see the color on it, but against the white backdrop, it was an absolutely gorgeous animal. So I could see he was a mature buck, which is the first thing that I always look for, and told to look for the body size. I could see he was mature. I looked at the antlers as he was looking at me, and I thought, oh, he's not the whitest buck in the world, though he's fairly wide. And then, of course, when he turned his head and gave me a look at his right side, I thought, well, he's at least a 10-point. So I pulled back down and squeezed the trigger off.
Thank you.
Thought it was a good shot. He went across the cut line to the west side, moving fairly slowly. So I think that was an indication that he wasn't feeling well. And Dean came out, brought Justin with him from another blind, and we went in and retrieved him. I don't think he got too far, maybe, 30, 40 feet in there. So that's always good that it's a easy retrieve. Clean deal. We definitely love that. So it's unbelievable. When I saw this deer on the ground, I just totally taken back. I thought maybe I would be looking at a 10-point, and when I saw all of the extras, particularly on the right side, I think there are 15 scoreable points on this buck. Excuse me. I was astounded. I thought this is so remarkable. So it's been another great year up here. Very much enjoy spending time with Dean and the other guides, and Wayne does a great job cooking. The accommodations are nice. Everything's good when you do this, and it's a very, very enjoyable time. So yeah, I'm thrilled. This is way beyond anything that I expected to harvest. So very, very happy.
Excellent. Well, congratulations, John. You deserve it. I really appreciate your guys' support for coming up and your patronage, and it's great having you guys in camp as well. And it's nice when you it's really nice to guide people who buy into the program of what it is we do, and you know, don't question it, just get in there, and just put in your time, because really it's as simple as that. Yeah. You know, we've done the work to find the good locations, and you just need to put in the time, and if you do, chances are good things are going to happen. It's as simple as that.
Yeah, well, it can get a little trying. There's no question. It's not an easy deal, particularly when you're up on a pod like that and it's, you know, well below zero. It can be a little bit stressful, but it's, as Dean said, it's perseverance. You just have to stick with it. And if you're willing to do that, then you heighten your opportunities of,
of that.
Harvesting something like this is, you know, my wife hates to hear the term, but I always like to say once in a lifetime. I think unquestionably that's exactly what this is, a once in a lifetime whitetail. I doubt I'll ever harvest anything of this magnitude again. So, yeah, a great, fantastic day. Thrilled. I'm happy that Mo was here to witness it.
It's been good.
In line. That's what his job is now. So I'm just thrilled.
Couldn't Excellent. Be happier. Congratulations again.
Alrighty, thank you.
Are we having fun?
Oh, absolutely.
More, are we having fun?
Uh-huh.
Why are we having fun?
Well, there's fun and then there's fun. It depends on the type of fun. This is utter fulfillment fun, is what this is.
I think you guys might have had a pretty good hunt.
Oh, shit.
Yeah, we both tagged out on nice mature bucks again this year, so another good trip.
Well, I think even beyond that, when you start getting it up in the 150 class like that buck, I mean, that big mature 300-pound whitetail like that, I mean, that's a rarity, and I think it's fair to say something with this number of points on it's a rarity, even in whitetail world, so... I think we went beyond this year.
I would
accomplish something I never forget any of them. I know you don't. Any of these things you remember forever. But this definitely will stand out, be right at the top of the memory list. Super, super, super.
Well done, boys. Well, I'm pretty sure there's a skin and shack that's calling my name.
Yeah, I want to maybe start cutting meat too before it freezes.
Yeah,
maybe
he'll be fresh. Yeah.
A bit, so.
Okay. Well, yeah. Let's get rolling.
Let's get her done.
Congratulations again, gentlemen.
Thank you. Well done. Thank you.
Well done.
You got us here. You got us lined out.
You'd recommend coming to this AWGS place or whatever?
Yeah. If you enjoy hunting and the memories. I think one of the few things you'll remember as long as maybe the birth of your children and a few things, but if you really like to hunt, it leaves some very strong fixed memories when you do something like this. It's a very bonding experience. If you enjoy hunting and you like big, mature whitetail, coming to Alberta, it's as good as it's going to get, so... If you can get in with somebody like Dean, AWGS, then, that's just extra. Makes it your chances so much better, and it's so much more comfortable and enjoyable. It's a fantastic experience.
Excellent. Amen is right. Amen. Let's get after it, boys.